Body's gonna be upright, nice and tall, and the chest wants to lean in just in front of the hips. You drive with the heels first, you get connected into the rower, and then the hips should drive back first. That's the first thing that should happen. As soon as you get to full leg extension, the body rocks over, and then the arms finish. And then you release in the same fashion, just to reverse the motion. So the whole stroke should look like this. That number that comes up represents the value of resistance. And what we want to focus on is getting a slower rate to allow them to focus on technique and movement and drive through what's called rhythm. So the harder you work to go an extra second faster has way more calories involved than it would do if you're going slower and wanted to go a second faster. The bigger the damper setting, the more air that gets driven in, the higher the resistance. Means that this is going to be harder to fall. Good, you don't need to worry too much about this, but when you're rowing, what should happen is there's a nice big arc and curve that comes onto here. This is only if you're really focusing on someone's technique.
That is,
when you're trying to reach all the way in there.
That's why I stopped here.
Yeah, you just need to stop there.